reaching the NCAA tournament in his first year in Raleigh, Kevin Keats once again has NC State on the verge of the field of 68. But for the Pack to keep their big dance bubble from bursting, a strong finish to the regular season is a must. Tonight, they square off with Georgia Tech and the backcourt tandem of Jose Alvarado and Michael DeVoe. The Pack and Jackets, next on ACC Hoops. NC State. Great to be with Mike Jaminski, Wes Durham. Welcome to our coverage. Facts are facts at this point in the season. Kevin Keats and NC State are 20-9, but 8-8 in conference play, Mike. I bet they sure would like to be 10-8.
Well, you know what, Wes? I think 9 wins gives them a .500 conference record guaranteed, but 10-8, and I think they're definitely in.
Well, it's interesting because the Wolfpack trying to make a push. Disappointing loss at Florida State, but Markell Johnson, the junior from Cleveland, our hearty star to watch, continues to shine.
He's overcome some midseason injuries, starting to get in better shape, Wes, right now. But the last two games have been outstanding, almost 20 points, 56% from the field, and lights out from behind the arc.
Well, it'll be an interesting backcourt matchup tonight, too, because Johnson and the Wolfpack face a young combination for Georgia Tech. The sophomore Alvarado, the freshman DeVoe, on fire the other night in the overtime win against BC.
Now, DeVoe has really come on strong late in the season. Alvarado is really the engine that drives this team. Look for NC State to lock in on them defensively.
All right, the Wolfpack pressure, the Jacket zone. Quite a matchup on a Wednesday night. We're live in Raleigh. NC State, Georgia Tech comes your way right after you see this.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by The Works Pegasus, your workspace, any place. Find it at your local Lowe's. Hardee's. And Toyota. Visit your local Toyota dealer today. Toyota, let's go places.
98th meeting all time between Georgia Tech and NC State here tonight. And a quick look at the starting lineups. Georgia Tech has lost sophomore Curtis Haywood, the second, for the remainder of the year with an ankle injury sustained the other night in the win against Boston College. So Khalid Moore, the freshman from Briarwood, New York, starts for just the fifth time against the conference, ninth time this season with Alvarado DeVoe. Moses Wright, who's got a homecoming of sorts, played at Enloe High School in Raleigh, and James Banks the third. And Mike Jaminski's four keys to the game tonight.
Well, you look at Georgia Tech, Wes, and they're going to want to control tempo in this game. They would want it to be in the 50s and 60s. NC State wants it in the 80s. And for State, pressure, pressure, pressure. They're going to try to wear down the backcourt of Georgia Tech, turn them over, offense to defense.
You see Kevin Keats, 41 wins in season number two here in Raleigh. They went 21-12 a year ago. He went 11-7 in ACC play. Finished tied for third. And Josh Pastor now in season three in Atlanta with 47 wins. Walker and Banks get us started. Ted Valentine, Michael Roberts, John Higgins on the whistle here tonight. The Jackets in gold. NC State in their alternate gray, if you will.
Really curious to see how Torndorn handles his emotions here early in this game. Always really, really tough when he realizes the last time you're going to play on this floor.
Khalid Moore draws the foul on the baseline drive, and we'll get free throws here early, and it's on Markell Johnson, the junior from Cleveland. There is Josh Pastner, 41-year-old native of Kingwood, Texas. Of course, had a very successful career at Memphis, and now in his third year at Georgia Tech. Moore is a 70% free throw shooter as Lynchburg, Virginia's Kevin Keats looks on. You see 12-5 at home against the ACC, and Khalid Moore knocks down the first 2 points of the ball game. Moore had just 3 points, 3 rebounds in Sunday night's win against Boston College, but Georgia Tech was sorting out their lineup after Haywood went out with the injury. The Haywood injury, a quick note here, Mike, for Josh Pastner, that is almost 6 points a ball game out of the Georgia Tech order, and it's tough enough for Pastner's team to get any offense in from a scoring production anyway.
It really is, a challenge to score more, just under 4 points a game. So as we say, in these situations, it's not just going to be one person stepping up and having a huge night.
Now, Georgia Tech is dead last in the ACC at 60.5 points a ball game in conference play. Beverly misses a deep three, and out of bounds it will belong to the Jackets, who are 1-7 on the road in the ACC.
Well, it's interesting, and you brought it up to Kevin Keats about the challenge of playing just a team one time this late in the year that plays such an unconventional defense in the half court, and how to, not enough preparation time.
Well, he talked about the simulation effect. Just don't have enough time to really, you probably need a week to simulate what they do defensively. So,
well, even if you tried, I said the same thing about Syracuse. You can play the zone, but it's not the same guy playing the zone.
Ball got stolen by Alvarado, or from Alvarado on the pass. Beverly stepped out of bounds. It'll stay with Georgia Tech. Down to our right here. Fortunate break for the Jackets, who gave it away on an unforced error. And they got a reset of the shot clock. Here's Banks around Wyatt Walker travel.
Banks has been all over the place. He's scored in double figures 14 times, underneath double figures 15 times.
Averaging 11-7 against the league is the Texas transfer, James Banks. Here is Walker. Right back for Beverly. Boy, right challenge quickly. 10 to shoot for the Wolfpack. Johnson against Alvarado. Takes him on the dribble. Lost the handle on it. Rolled around. DeVoe comes away with a turnover.
And so far, the Wolfpack really having trouble with this defense.
Alvarado, 2 minutes in. Three-pointer off. And a rebound for Walker and a hit for Bryce. C.J. Bryce's three is off.
Had a good look at it. But from Alvarado, that's the type of shot that really NC State wants. They want them playing, their tempo, and gave them a break they didn't take advantage of.
What a tough shot for Alvarado. Challenging Walker on the drive, and it's 4-0 Georgia Tech.
I think you could use that word tough about everything about Alvarado and his demeanor, how he plays the game.
There's Dorn slashing baseline. Mike, is he at his best when he challenges you on the bounce?
Yeah, and it's funny. And Kevin Keats told us it allows him to play small, but Dorn plays big. He's so good as a rebounder. Great shooter, but can also take it off the dribble.
3 minutes in, Georgia Tech by a basket. And DeVoe fouled on the reach by Beverly. His first, second on the Wolfpack.
Well, and here it is. This guy's fearless, and there's not really a rim protector in there for North Carolina State, so you can go to the rim, and then here you just nice little pull-up jump shot using the glass. He wanted to get off to a good start, probably feels a lot more comfortable after that make.
Devin Daniels and DJ Funderburk into the lineup for NC State for the first time. A couple of quick changes just beyond 3 minutes gone. Well, first half for Kevin Keats.
Well, Funderburk gives you more of a scoring option inside as opposed to Walker.
Moore. DeVoe, who had a really good ball game Sunday night. Back for Moore and a shot clock violation on Georgia Tech.
Pretty good defensive series that time for the Wolfpack.
Third turnover for Josh Pastner's team. Markel Johnson now with Devin Daniels and Torin Dorn and DJ Funderburk on the floor, along with Beverly. Here's Dorn slashing again. Banks got a hand on it. Leads Georgia Tech with 70 blocks coming into the ball game. And one of the better shot blockers in the ACC is James Banks, the third. Funderburk, nice pass and another block. Banks got that one on the reverse by Dorn. Here's right at the other end. Moses Wright took an awkward pass, but had enough momentum to get the ball up over the rim for his first field goal.
Yeah, and he's actually coming on late for this team, too. Got a couple double-figure games in the last three.
And 10 against BC Sunday night. Georgia Tech a four-point edge here. Foul line area for Funderburk. Johnson with seven to shoot. Markell will take it on the drive. Funderburk the rebound and the layup. Second field goal for NC State belongs to DJ Funderburk out of Cleveland.
Well, that was a great play by Funderburk because he followed in on the drive. It drew Georgia Tech's front line over to try to block that shot, and he was wide open in the middle of the front of the rim.
To lead Moore. Here's DeVoe. Now Banks, a long two-pointer at the front. James Banks shoots 54% from the floor. And Georgia Tech's got four different scores in their 8 points.
So Wesley's one of those guys that gets going early. It certainly helps his confidence.
Daniels tried to slip it to Funderburk, deflected away, and turned over to Banks. Third turnover for NC State. Moore tries to get an alley to the rim. Funderburk there, and Dorn cleaned it up. Bounce pass Johnson to breaking Funderburk for the layup.
And that was just being sloppy getting back defensively by Georgia Tech. Nobody got turned around, especially your frontline players, Wes. You got to get turned around and identify where the ball is.
NC State to within two. Moses Wright on the drive. Runs it up on the glass for his second field goal. Four for Wright. Georgia Tech scoring it probably at a higher clip, Mike, than they have in most of the ACC campaigns. Here, at least in the first 6 minutes.
Yeah, and they're looking to push ahead.
Alvarado. Kevin Keats did tell us he's willing to concede a couple of backdoor cuts in order to get some deflections, and there's Banks on the slip and the dunk.
Yeah, right on your call on that Princeton-style offense. You get extended a little bit, but you have to be willing to give up a few things I didn't want to see it happening all night long.
Here's Johnson, a long three. Funderburk, the quick rebound and stick back. And DJ Funderburk coming off 18-9 at Tallahassee. He's got six off Kevin Keats' bench.
Well, I was going to say, Wes, since he's come in, there's been much better production inside offensively.
Banks, left-hand jump hook, rattles in. So Banks and Funderburk clearing things off. Both big kids have six. We get a break in the action. James Banks has got six to lead Georgia Tech. Slips the screen, gets the dunk. Georgia Tech by half dozen. Georgia Tech by six, 14-8. Tonight's well-planned play is brought to you by Principal Financial. And who knew DJ Funderburk would come with the scoring punch right off of Kevin Keats' bench. And James Banks, coming off an 8-of-9 night against Boston College, is three of his first three here tonight for Georgia Tech.
For NC State, Funderburk has really saved them here early. And, Georgia Tech, Wes, as you know, and you can see them a lot this year, they are capable of big scoring nights. They average on the year, though, in 60 in conference, and they started out 6 of 8 from the floor.
10 of 19 are the two schools. The St. Louis freshman Jericho Helms with the ball. Out of the timeout, here's Daniels for three. It spins out for Funderburk. Another rebound and stick back, Mike.
Those are nights where the ball comes to you. He was not on the side where it would normally rebound, but it spun around. He was right in front of it.
You get a sense early. Is that what happens to you?
Yeah.
If I stand right here, it'll come right here, right? There's Banks back to work. How about the two bigs now? Good thing we talked about the backcourt to start the game tonight.
we haven't mentioned them a whole lot.
No, we had it covered right from the jump, didn't we? A little more pop in this from a scoring perspective than I think we expected early, too. Here's C.J. Bryce. Helms tried to get it back to Bryce, deflected away. Alvarado the turnover, Michael DeVoe. Nice feed for Moore in the dunk.
Really unselfish play that time. DeVoe could have gone up over the top of Beverly, but gave it up for an easier layup.
Georgia Tech's on their largest lead here in this first half at 8 points. And the Jackets back into this zone that looks like a 1-3-1, Mike. Flips around to a 2-3. It's almost like the secret sauce.
Yeah, it's interesting, though, Wes, that NC State has had good success off the dribble attacking the middle of that zone. And when they've missed, Funderburk's been there to clean things up. But the drive is available.
It's interesting because you and I have seen Georgia Tech enough this year to know everybody's kind of got their own theories about how to get in front of it and create the crease, if you will. Helms the rebound of a DeVoe miss. Oh, Beverly left wide open for three. Banks the rebound. Quick outlet. Here's Moore streaking to the other end, and Khalid Moore will draw the foul from Jericho Helms. His first and the third on NC State. Michael DeVoe in transition. Georgia Tech by six.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina. Be bold, be confident, live fearless, North Carolina. North Myrtle Beach. It's not just a beach trip. It's South Carolina's most surprising getaway. Get inspired at ExploreNorthMyrtleBeach.com. And Husqvarna. All-star lawns start with auto mower. For a perfect lawn 24-7, Husqvarna. Ready when you are.
Well, NC State's last ACC tournament title, 1987 at the Capitol Center. They beat Carolina in the title game. Vinny Del Negro, the MVP. Georgia Tech's last ACC tournament title, 93 at the old Charlotte Coliseum. The one out there on Hive Drive where the G-Man used to start. James Forrest, the MVP. And both of them beat top seed Carolina in the championship game.
Well, and, you know, you look at that group of coaches that came in, Coach K and Jim Valvano and Bobby Kremins, they're really, I think, reinvigorated Coach Smith and helped him coach a little bit longer than he might have. He took on the challenge, as did they.
Devin Daniels knocks down the three. And NC State, a big bucket. Banks traveled with it. Good help. Send it back to the Wolfpack.
Yeah. Good help on the weak side that time.
Watch Daniels here, Mike.
Yeah, to watch him move and good cut. Got a great look. Working the top of that zone.
NC State now getting a big three-point goal from Daniels, their first of the ball game.
Wes, I'm wondering when we'll see more full-court pressure from NC State. You know, they talked about getting into Alvarado, especially up the floor, and trying to wear him down because he's got a ton of 40-minute games this year.
Bryce working against A.D. Gay, who's come in. Here's Daniels. Nice pass. Wyatt Walker, the layup. State starting to find some rhythm against the zone.
Yep, absolutely. They're starting to figure it out. Again, it's been a lot of penetration inside, and after that made field goal, it allows them to get into pressure.
And there's the turnover. Five on Georgia Tech. Pack can take the lead here. Bryce shoots for the advantage. And A.D. Gay, the rebound. Inside of 10 to go. This game still got a little tempo to it.
Well, and I think that NC State might have got caught a little off guard by Georgia Tech's willingness to run the floor early.
Moses Wright's got a half dozen in his homecoming game to Raleigh. First time he's had a chance to play here in his hometown as a Yellow Jacket, because a year ago Georgia Tech and NC State only played in Atlanta in a single game. Johnson for three. And A.D. Gay the rebound. Boy, Gay's been a nice surprise for Pastner this year.
Yep.
In a redshirt senior season. Comes in averaging 9 points, almost four rebounds against the conference. DeVoe tried to skip it to Alvarado, turned over.
Georgia Tech a little sloppy the last couple of possessions.
Dorn for the lead. Here's Alvarado.
He's got nobody to running with him. He was looking around, but a nice little
Austin.
Yeah, nice little dump back.
So Brandon Austin, the grad transfer from Lehigh in his senior year, on the board. He was scoreless the other night against Boston College. So 22-17, it's a 5-point Georgia Tech lead. Daniels, here's Bryce. And the rebound for Wright.
The shots have been there, two of the both elbows in that zone as well.
Georgia Tech is 10 of 13 from the floor, Mike. They're coming off a 50% night against Boston College. They've shot the ball 50% or better three times against the league. Obviously have won all three. They have eight of them this year. Here's Daniels off the turnover, which is number seven, and Dorn the layup.
Yeah, that's again, Georgia Tech a little loose with the basketball, but, you know, shooting it extremely well.
So Dorn has four, and the turnover starting to mount here for Josh Pastor's team.
Let's see if they took their foot off the gas here a little bit, get a little bit more deliberate in each possession.
There's another turnover, and here is Daniels for the dunk.
Well, what did Josh Pastor tell you about? Live ball turnovers, pick sixes. It's, you know, those are the things you can't give up. And
well, back to back, Mike. Here's the first one, and then Daniels the punch and the dunk over his head. How about that? NC State to within one when we come back to Raleigh. One-point lead for Georgia Tech, under 7 minutes to go here in the first half, and our Toyota Let's Go Places tonight focuses on the details of NC State's resume, Mike. Net ranking of 31. You see the quality wins, the bad loss, and now all of a sudden, and I thought we had a fairly candid conversation before the game with Kevin Keats.
And he was talking about scheduling teams that they thought were going to have better seasons than they did, whether it's because of injury or just not playing well. And the one thing I would have liked to have seen, Wes, is a win by NC State against one of the top five teams in the conference. I think that really would have solidified something for this ball club. But that being said, you get to 10-8 in this conference, you're in the tournament.
That's what I think.
9-9, it may even be good enough.
Sure. Well, and especially when they're talking about other potential at-large teams having losing records, and Mike, quite frankly, a league not as good as this one.
Yep. It's been consistently 6-7 teams in the top 25 in this conference just through the course of the year.
Dorn for the lead. Boy, Moses Rice played very well, but a foul on Brandon Austin battling DJ Funderburg. And that is the first foul on Georgia Tech in the half.
There are already three blocks by the Yellow Jackets, and got up on that one. Great timing by Wright.
Moses Wright, who spent his youth as a tennis player, late to basketball here in Raleigh at Enloe High School. And gone to the monitor here. John Higgins is standing with the basketball. All right, so we'll see if there's, see if they're looking for the hook and hold here underneath.
Yeah,
Funderburk and Austin.
Austin looked like he had the inside arm right there.
Yeah, sure does, doesn't he?
Yeah. Man, I'd have been out of the game in 10 minutes if that was called on me. This is, right now NC State has 11 more field goal attempts than Georgia Tech. When Georgia Tech is taking care of the ball, they're extremely efficient, but they've got eight turnovers and they've given up nine turnovers now, and they've given up five offensive rebounds.
Yep. And of those five offensive rebounds, NC State's done a great job, DJ Funderburk in particular, Michael Putbacks.
Yep.
In fact, of Funderburk's 8 points, I want to think six of them are on putbacks.
Boy, and I really don't like that long inbounds pass from underneath out of bounds. That one came very close to being stolen as well. And I also don't think that once you've advanced the ball over half court, you should be able to go into the back court again to receive it.
Yeah.
I'd like to see that rule change.
NC State's had three or four possessions to take the lead, and there is a held ball that will go to the Wolfpack. What's a nice tie-up by Alvarado. Or DeVoe, beg your pardon. Freshman from Orlando.
And he got lucky because a lot of times the referees will not reward a reach in like that, but he was fortunate to come up with all ball, and it was a good call.
DeVoe sets up Daniels. Long three, Alvarado. Here's Georgia Tech again, rushing the floor. Right inside and draws the foul. So Moses Wright with a little offensive initiative. DJ Funderburk, his first and the fourth team foul on NC State.
We talked about our star to watch at the top. And Markel Johnson's not scored in this game, Wes. 0-3, 0-2 from behind the arc.
Introducing Pegasus, a next generation all-in-one work table and clamping system.
Moses Wright hit the first. He has seven. C.J. Bryce back for Devin Daniels in the Wolfpack order.
And Beverly is yet to scratch in this game as well. So they're fortunate that they're only two behind right now.
Yep.
Three behind.
Yep. Under six to go. NC State has had some moments here where they've been very, very efficient against the Georgia Tech zone. Here's Dorn, who got off to a nice start. Johnson, 10 to shoot very quickly for the Wolfpack. Funderburk on the baseline. Right the rebound.
Yeah, on that possession, they were positioned perfectly in front of whoever had the ball, and nobody really had a clean look.
The Jackets on fire here in the first half. And this is from a team 10th in the league against the conference in field goal shooting at under 42%.
What?
Seven to shoot, and Georgia Tech gets the ball in the deflection.
And that's the peril that you have, Wes, when you let a team come into your building and get comfortable, which Georgia Tech certainly did. And, they were probably expecting a whole different pace, but Georgia Tech had other things on their mind.
Offensive foul called by Ted Valentine on Michael DeVoe.
Who also has yet to score in this game.
First on DeVoe, the second on Georgia Tech. And another look here.
Oh, wow. He's looking. Got his forearm up pretty high. Through a couple people trying to fight through a screen.
So DeVoe paid for it with his second. Three-point game, and the Wolfpack on the attack. Left side Bryce. And Alvarado the rebound.
Wow, and there are a lot of three-point shots that NC State has gotten in this game, West. They can't complain about the look. I got to think that Kevin keeps saying, yes, that's a good shot. They just haven't been able to knock them down.
NC State's 1-for-11 from behind the line. And Dorn missed the jumper at the foul line. And punched away as he battled DeVoe for the rebound. And last touch by Michael DeVoe.
I think he sees his team struggling, and Dorn may be pushing a little bit too much right now.
Beverly. Johnson, rather than turn to the basket, pushed it back out. Here's Funderburk fighting down and a dunk. Oh, DJ Funderburk. Double figures for the sixth time in the last eight ball games. And the fifth field goal, the most emphatic. Can the Jackets respond here as we go inside of 4 minutes? Khalid Moore almost turned it over. Five to shoot for Alvarado. inside against Funderburk. They crash the glass. Moses Wright called for the travel. Josh Pastor not happy with the call. DJ Funderburk, a vicious punch with the right hand. State to within one. CPI Security presents Protecting the Paint. Mike, pretty easy when you talk about Georgia Tech in the zone.
Yeah, that's, it, you know, really helps things out on the perimeter when you got to have guys inside who can clean up. They've got three blocks on the game, Wes, and a good tie-up as well. But, you know, we thought this was going to be a battle of the backcourts, and it's really been, it's been the guys up front. I mean, you look at Funderburk. He's 5 of 7 in 9 minutes. The rest of the team is 6 of 24 from the floor.
DJ Funderburk, double figures. And Blake Harris has entered the ballgame, number 55 for the Wolfpack for the first time. So Kevin Keats has now played all 9 of his guys on this short Wolfpack bench. Funderburk missed the long 2.
6 of 20 from 3 on the year, but you know, you get a game like this where you're going, maybe it's not the worst thing in the world to step out a little bit and see if the jumper's working as well.
Khalid Moore, a 3. Now just 5 of 16 on the year is Moore from behind the line. Diagonal pass, Dorn the scoop. Banks kept it alive in the rebound.
Well, right now, Georgia Tech isn't even sending anybody to the offensive glass. They want to get all 5 back in transition.
Here's Banks weaving around Funderburk, reverses back and scores.
We talked about him being up and down, but he is certainly up here this evening. Big lift inside.
Double figures for Banks. On his 5th field goal, he's 5 for 5, which makes him 13 out of 14 in the last 2 ball games. And a travel by Beverly gives it back to Georgia Tech, Mike.
Yeah, and this is a really sound feed. Look, he goes baseline, which you never give up, and sees that come up. And just nice sweats when you have good balance, comes back to that right jump hook.
Hey, I know you well enough to know you like the footwork out of the big guys, don't you?
I liked it even better when no double team was coming down, too. It gave you a little chance to work. But you know, Wes, when you face up like that against a post guy, it puts a lot of pressure on him to defend.
Coming up on 2 minutes. 3-point lead for Georgia Tech. DeVoe. Funderburk got a piece of it on the way up. Helms with Bryce. Here's Beverly. NC State trying to find the crease against the zone. Helms of triple. Funderburk the rebound and fouled by Moore on the stick back.
It almost looks like that zone right now is geared to covering up the perimeter, and they're willing maybe to give up some inside points to Funderburk.
Third foul on Georgia Tech. The first on the Briarwood, New York freshman Khalid Moore, and DJ Funderburk is the 7th best free throw shooter in the ACC. And these are the first free throws of the night for NC State, who hits almost 73% against the league.
And that's a rarity as well for, look at that, his contribution with regard to the rest of the team. Basically keeping them afloat. And that's another thing, you talk about the high free throw percentage for a big, you don't see that a lot.
Christian Scholin did not play the other night in the ball game against Boston College. He's come on for Georgia Tech, and we get a foul in the backcourt on Beverly. That'll be his 2nd and number 5 on the Wolfpack.
Not a lot of whistles being blown tonight. They're letting them play, and nobody even close to getting into the bonus right now with a minute 44 left.
Here is Scholin, who started 4 ball games, Mike, for Georgia Tech. They're giving them a little offensive punch. And Scholin stepped out of bounds. Another turnover for Georgia Tech. It's their 12th here in the first half. And here is Moore back for Christian Scholin. Josh Pastor puts Scholin in there maybe to try and get a shot off, but wants to get Moore back on the
offense for defense.
Even with
85 seconds to go in the first half. It's a one-point ball game.
And Wes, you know, despite the pace, the points have not followed the pace of the game.
No. Not from what we had early, right? Daniels for the lead. Got it. First lead of the night for the Wolfpack. Eight for Devin Daniels.
Well, it's an important minute for Georgia Tech right now. They don't want NC State to go on a little mini run going into halftime.
Alvarado trying to beat Johnson. Thunderbird smacked it off the glass. Wolfpack in transition with Harris. Daniels now will gun for three again. 11 for Daniels. He and Thunderbird have 23 of the Wolfpack's 31.
Yeah, that was a wise timeout to take. You know, not going to be able to carry that one over, and he was going nowhere. It was an 8-0 run by the Wolfpack here in this stretch to spread it out a little bit.
Well, Devin Daniels, huge here, Mike.
Yeah, take a look at it, and very unselfish play. This is, again, the attack in the seam of the zone and the good spot up right there. And then Alvarado just trying to do a little bit too much, and Thunderbird starts the break in another three. I still see Johnson, though, he's a little reluctant to take this shot, but feed it to the hot hand. Devin Daniels is 3 of 5 from three.
Pretty strong half for Daniels and Thunderbird. Georgia Tech with about a 6-second differential. Shot clock to game clock as we wind down this first half at PNC Arena in Raleigh. Scholin back on the floor.
Well, NC State has lived on that. Their points off the bench, 31 on the year.
Alvarado squeezes through traffic. Scholin, a nice pass. And great catch by Alvarado for his second field goal. A timeout taken, use it or lose it for Kevin Keats with 8.4 to go. And his team up 3 points. Well, DJ Thunderbird now, Mike. 6'10 sophomore transfer has had quite the first half here.
And he was the one who really got them back in the ball game, coming off the bench early, giving them offensive rebounding, running the floor extremely well. Second chance points, his offense, and then that was the highlight of the first half for NC State.
NC State's got 12 second chance points. Georgia Tech, nothing.
Well, and again, I think that's a function of the pace that NC State wants to run at. It tends to take guys off the offensive glass. And then look at the bench points, 23-2 right now.
Yeah, well, Thunderbird and Daniels. There you go.
And then the other guys at the bench will take credit for that, too.
Markel Johnson and a foul by Alvarado.
One to give.
Alvarado, number 10.
4th on Georgia Tech and number 1 on Alvarado. Here is Markel. Went for the dunk. Banks blocked it. Johnson somehow recovered the deflection and scored it. First points for Markel Johnson in the first half.
Well, look at the initial play. But then Johnson staying after it and just got the ball up in time.
Well, you said it, Mike. Pretty critical last minute and a half for Georgia Tech and NC State.
Yeah, and some turnovers, points off defense, a little spurt here in a game that was bogging down some, but...
Five. Stay tuned. Hardy's Halftime Report coming up from PNC Arena in Raleigh right after this. Welcome you back to Raleigh in tonight's edition of the Hardee's Halftime Report. Here at the break, North Carolina State leads Georgia Tech 33-28. Great to be with ACC Hoops and Mike Jaminski. Wes Durham, welcome back courtside here. Fascinating opening 20 minutes. Start off one way, finish probably like we thought the ball game would go.
Right, and you know, for NC State, the bench really carried them to this lead. Let's see if the starters show up. Also, if their three-point shooting shows up, where it can really stretch the lead out. And if you're Josh Pastner, you're talking about a couple things: turnovers, 12 in that first half, and offense and cleaning up the defensive glass.
Well, if NC State needs a win tonight, Clemson certainly needs a win, and the Tigers are in South Bend. And they find themselves deadlocked with Notre Dame, 32-all. Marquise Reed leads Clemson. John Mooney, of course, leads Notre Dame.
You know, and I think we, you know, we talked about, you know, it's coming up for selection of all tournament and all ACC teams, and both of those guys I think are deserving of. And you know, but for Mooney, it's going to be really hard. He's had a terrific year, but with the record that the Notre Dame has, it's going to be tough.
Well, Clemson, no question, needs the win tonight. Syracuse at home on Saturday for the Tigers. DJ Funderburk, a big half. We'll talk about it after this.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina. Be bold, be confident, live fearless, North Carolina. Your local Ford dealer. And CPI Security, the official security partner of the ACC.
Hardy's halftime report continues from Raleigh. Devin Daniels, 11 points, including 3 of 5 from behind the line. Helped the Wolfpack to a 5-point lead at the break.
ACC College Hoops is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the ACC. GEICO. New York Life. Bojangles Famous Chicken and Biscuits. Food Lion and Toyota.
Appropriate to see the father of the ACC tournament, Everett Case, as we rejoin you from Raleigh. NC State 33, Georgia Tech 28. Welcome back courtside with Mike Jaminski, Wes Durham. Okay, we've kind of seen this thing unfold. The bench points have to be a concern for Josh Pastner, but his team shot it pretty well in the first half.
That's a, you know, I think the key thing is for them to, you know, make their mistakes up on the rim. When they take control of the basketball, they've shot it very, very well. But just too big a disparity. Only, you know, the Wolfpack has twice as many field goal attempts as Georgia Tech.
All right, we'll keep an eye on it, as well as the -7 turnover margin for James Banks and Georgia Tech. Second half next from Raleigh. Five-point lead for NC State. 23 of their 33 have come from the bench, Mike. Doesn't take long to figure it out because it's DJ Funderburk and Devin Daniels who sparked the end of the half.
Well, and it was Funderburk who really got him back into the game early on with his offensive rebounding. And then, you know, for NC State, Devin Daniels came in and really sealed the deal. And it was that little spurt in the last minute and a half of the first half that gave them some cushion. But I'd like to see both of these teams' backcourt show up here. And let's see if Markel Johnson tries to get going early and Torm Doran the same way.
By the way, Johnson got the bucket to close the half, and that was the only marker out of either he or Braxton Beverly for Kevin Keats. Torm Doran had 2 field goals.
I think playing right now, Devotion, he's got a big size advantage over Beverly. He should try to take advantage of that.
Right on the crossover, turned it over. Nope, got it. Shot clock violation, though.
Yeah, they're both bigs, both front courts have played very well in this game so far, but I don't know that Josh Pastner wants Moses Wright putting on the deck that much that far away from the basket.
13 turnovers now for Georgia Tech. They start the half.
At least that one was a dead ball turnover, so you can get back and set your defense. Not a great start, but you take a positive out of it.
Johnson lost a handle on it. He almost gave it away. They'll roll to the deck with it. Alvarado's got it. Made the save for DeVoe. Here's Moses Wright for the dunk. 10 for Wright.
Showing out for the people back home.
Third double-figure game of the last four. Started with 19 at Miami. And Moses Wright kind of rounding in the form here at the close of his sophomore campaign. Dorn missed badly. And NC State gets the offensive rebound. Beverly to... Can't make him pay with the three.
Boy, you know, Wright's got some great length, and I think he's perfectly suited to that defense out on the perimeter because he can cover a lot of space, and he can clean up things inside as well.
We both thought about that lefty three. Quickly, here's Banks, who's had a really good half offensively. He'll reverse back up and in, and Jake Banks has got a dozen in the ball game, and he's 6 for 6 from the floor, Mike.
And he continues to have a long day to work inside. No double team coming. He just took his time, recognized that, made a beautiful shot.
1 point game, 2 minutes into the half. Rice with a step back. Left it short. Banks battling Dorn. And there's Bryce and a foul on Alvarado. Second on Alvarado, first on the Jackets.
Johnson got in trouble here, but this is just hustle on the part of the Yellow Jackets, and Alvarado picked up the foul before, but look at the run out that time. And then the deep catch. And it's not easy. You know, you have to have a counter move to your move. He obviously wants to go to his right hand, but had the presence of mind to come back with his left.
Thunderbirds come on the floor quickly to spell Walker. Just a couple minutes into this second half.
And that's when things turn around in the first half when that substitution was made.
Beverly beat right off the dribble, dumps it inside, and there's Funderburk for the dunk. 14 for DJ Funderburk, and he's having a pretty good ball game from the floor.
See, for Beverly, you can't draw two bigs on that play. And that's what allowed Funderburk to get that dunk. And, you know, one guy could have blocked a shot. You've got to make him finish.
Here's Banks, the catch. And lost it out of bounds before he got the shot off. And it's turned over to NC State on the 14th giveaway. And here's Funderburk a moment ago.
Yeah, here's the thing. See the draw on the pitch. There's nobody there. Everybody sucked into the drive.
3-point lead for the Pack. 3 minutes gone, second half. NC State trying to get to 9 ACC wins. It would be their 21st on the year. Daniels had it blocked by Banks. And here's Georgia Tech quickly up court with Moore. To lead Moore in traffic, scores. His second field goal.
Not bad transition defense, but a better shoe come off down at the other end for Torin Dorn.
But Moore had 4 in the first half. Second field goal gives him 6. Daniels is open down here in the corner. Skip it the opposite way to Dorn. 8 to shoot. Markel Johnson launches.
Well, and when things aren't going your well, as I've said it before, it's really tough to shoot your way into it with a 3. Try to get something going to the hoop. Get the free throw line. Work your way into it.
NC State's attempted 21 more field goals than Georgia Tech has in the ballgame.
Turnovers and offensive rebounds.
And it's a 1-point game. And that ball hit off the foot of an NC State player. It will stay with the Jackets when we continue from Raleigh. Well, down 5 at the break. Moses Wright trying to pick up Tech here in half 2. State 35, Georgia Tech 34. We're early second half in our game summary tonight. Brought to you by Hardee's because it tastes better. Georgia Tech still shooting 65% from the floor tonight, G.
Well, we talk about the disparity in the number of field goal attempts, but both teams have made 15 shots from the floor. And, you know, just a great percentage night for the Yellow Jackets.
Offensive rebounds, second chance points, and those are the two stars tonight. We talked about backcourt guys when we started. It's turned into a G-man special, a postman yep. game.
Thank you very much.
Yep. I knew you'd like it. Alvarado tend to shoot with Wright. Well, Banks handling with 5. Here's Jose. They got to make it happen now. Runner, no basket, and Josh Pastor was begging for continuation, didn't get it.
I think that went beyond begging and almost got him a little bit of a whistle.
The foul is on Daniels. It's his first, number one of the half on State. DeVoe runs it up, draws the foul from Beverly, and there's the matchup you were talking about.
Yeah, so just got to get him inside, you know, whether it's a post up or off the drive. I just think that he's got a big size advantage.
So Michael DeVoe played at Montverde Academy with R.J. Barrett a season ago to the line for a pair of free throws.
I can sign 12 autographs in 6 seconds. So reminding you to check your battery this fast, easy.
First point for DeVoe. Georgia Tech takes the lead for the first time since it was 26-25. DeVoe on the board with his first points. Johnson tries to put State back in front. Doran had it picked from behind by Alvarado. Jose wants a screen or something, and Banks going to try and help, but here's DeVoe. 5 minutes gone, second half. Fall away with a left hand and last touch by Georgia Tech, says John Higgins.
Yeah, trying to, looks like they're slowing down a little bit in the half court, and Georgia Tech and DeVoe trying to follow up on that last made shot, see if he still had the touch.
So you like the tempo at the start of the ball game to Georgia Tech's favor, right?
Yes, and I think they're going to, you know, I think they're going to try to slow it down a little bit.
Doran with six on his third basket.
Conversely, on made baskets, NC State's going to try to hurry them up on the other end.
Alvarado bounced out on a pretty clean look.
You can look. No offensive rebound presence whatsoever.
Beverly hit the side of the glass. And Ted Valentine said that maybe Wright deflected that. Michael DeVoe, who had 20, including a huge three in the overtime on Sunday night for Georgia Tech. For the win against Boston College, just 2 points and only, Mike, three attempts from the floor.
Yeah.
Oh! Markel Johnson with a little razzle-dazzle on the lob for Doran.
Well, we have seen some serious dunks in this game.
Four assists for Johnson. I think he might have flipped this behind his head. In air, flipped it behind his head toward the basket for Doran. Yep.
That's just knowing where your teammate is going to be. That's not showmanship right there. But a beautiful, that was right on the money, too.
Foul on Johnson at the other end. Third on NC State, and then Georgia Tech gave it right away. With their 15th turnover.
Getting the sense that maybe another little spurt is coming here for NC State. Momentum definitely swinging their way.
3-point lead for the Wolfpack. Beverly clutched on one from the logo. Another pass. There's Doran. Tried to get inside. Turned it over. Here's a lead for DeVoe. Weaves through. Blocked by Daniels out of bounds. We've seen some dunks and we've seen some rejections.
I'll tell you what, Wes. I kind of agree. This wasn't the game we were expecting, but that was a terrific Daniels doing it all offensively in the first half and then saving 2 points right there.
Alvarado slips it for Banks. Here's DeVoe. Right back for Banks. One dribble, went for the dunk, draws the foul.
On both ends of the floor, it's been that dribble drive penetration and then the dunk, you know, rather the lob for the dunk or the play for the foul right there.
Second on Thunderbird, fourth on the Wolfpack. Banks to the line where he's 69%. He's got a dozen on 6 field goals. First free throw of the night, good. For James Banks, the third. From Decatur, Georgia, transfer from Texas.
And the second one through. Interesting ball game. NC State in desperate need of a win. And then maybe need to double down on Saturday at Conte Forum against Boston College. Beverly at three. Alvarado on the run out. Tried to get it to Wright. It got deflected. And Dorn made the save, but Wright. Alvarado at three. Bounced out. And Johnson the rebound.
Yeah, that's the thing about this league, Wes. You know, we talked about it. It seemed like NC State, and they do have everything to play for. They're playing at home. Senior night, last home game. And Georgia Tech came in here and is giving them everything they want.
Foul on Alvarado's his third. It's the second on Georgia Tech. And DJ Funderburk, who's had a whale of a night so far, to the line for a pair.
And if you remember, we didn't think it meant much, but remember at the end of the first half, Alvarado gave away that foul just to stop the play with about 6 seconds to go. All of a sudden now, that's looming kind of large.
Because Johnson hits the final shot.
Yep. Yeah, Johnson hits the shot, and now he's got three personal fouls.
Funderburk missed the front end. 15 points now after his third free throw. And Jericho Helms. And C.J. Bryce is going to try and squeeze into the lineup as well, and does, as Beverly will go.
And the waves continue. You get some length on the front of that press with Beverly out there. And 10 guys for NC State average over 10 minutes a game. So that's been Kevin Geitz's M.O. all year long.
DeVoe working against Daniels. Here's Banks at the post. Backdoor cut, Wright the flush. 12 for Wright.
And that was not an easy pass or catch, but great high-low action that time between the two.
Wright is 6 for 6 from the floor.
Don't be wasting the lead.
Banks is 6 for 6, and he's 5 of 5.
Yeah. 40 all the ball game. Alvarado through traffic. Look at this. Just a game of circles. Wright tried to make the catch. Daniels pushed it away. It will stay with Georgia Tech when play resumes. But right now, James Banks getting after it. So's Moses Wright. Locked up at 40 in Raleigh. Play time for tonight's Honda Startup, brought to you by Honda Dealers of the Carolinas. Markel Johnson, service for Torin Doran. Look at this thing.
Yeah, just knowing where your teammate's going to be, and again, that back part of the zone vulnerable, and then the high-low action. Banks, both of them perfect from the floor this evening, and most of them have been shots like that.
They've got 26 of Georgia Tech's 40 to Wright and Banks. 11 for 11 from the floor, 4 of 4 at the line, and they both have 12 rebounds. And DeVoe's scoop and score is his first field goal. Back in front goes Georgia Tech.
NC State with a little better matchup, I think, with Bryce on him, but DeVoe's still able to take advantage of it.
Helms missed everything. And Alvarado. Look at that. The rest of the team, 5 of 17. Alvarado feeds Banks.
And credit the Georgia Tech guards. I mean, they get penetration and all. It's really been a dump drill for those two guys this whole game.
4-point lead for the Yellow Jackets.
Funderburk just kind of lurking on that baseline, trying to find an open spot.
Johnson a three. That's a big one for Markel.
Yeah, he needs a really strong last 10 minutes. And, maybe that's the shot that gets him going.
Trims the Jackets' advantage down to one. DeVoe. Alvarado. There's Banks well out. trying to find an alley, and a whistle and a foul. Michael Roberts. And the foul on Funderburk is third.
I mean, so many bodies it draws over, and, you know, when the shot blocker leaves you, all you do is follow him right to the front of the rim. And that shot well contested, high hand on it, but a better jump shot for Johnson.
Helms and Bryce go out of the ball game. Torin Doran has come back with Devin Daniels. And Ted Valentine to the scorer's table. And the ball will be put in play, almost a dangerous inbounds pass.
But I think last couple possessions he's been dribbling the ball an awful lot, and you know, just a little bit more passing in the offense, but you can't argue with the result.
He's got six in the ball game now. We'll lead three again. Doran in traffic and will not get the basket, but does draw the foul. So a pair of free throws for Torin Doran. After the foul on Khalid Moore, his second, third against Georgia Tech. And here is Doran, 60% at the free throw line. Both his dad, Torin Sr., his brother, Miles, former football players. Torin Sr., outstanding running back and in the NFL for a long time out of North Carolina. His brother, Miles, in the secondary for the Tar Heels, both here tonight. Very nice moment for Torin Doran, the only roster senior for NC State this year, and he got one or two at the line. But Kevin Keats offered some interesting insight on Doran before the ball game, too, about number of schools, coaching changes, AAU, high school, that kind of thing. Five coaches in about, what, 6 years?
Yeah, and been, you know, going to start in Charlotte and then coming here and talk about the ability to adapt. And he couldn't think of a finer young man to have in his program, both, you know, on the court and the way he conducts himself off the court as well.
Yep. DeVoe on the inbounds to Banks. Seven to shoot for Georgia Tech. Wright. Three ball away. Moses Wright. His fifth three of the year, Mike. Some nights it's your night.
And that's out of 23 or 24 attempts, so it's not like he's, you know, taking a few of them. But, I mean, we talked about it. That basket seems to get a little bit bigger the more you make.
Doran a three, trying to answer. Daniels had it. DeVoe finally the rebound. 8:40 to go. Screen of Banks. Tried to put it up, got it blocked. Here's Doran on the run out. Doesn't have numbers. Johnson, a step back three. Doran the rebound, lost it on the way up. It'll belong to Georgia Tech.
They're going to call him. Good piece of the officiating there, but that's the thing. The other thing that Kevin Keith said about Doran, that he's a great rebounder for his size, even though he didn't come up with that one.
Georgia Tech breaks the press, and Alvarado in one. Jose Alvarado with eight. And Mike, he's the one-man fast break.
Well, and that's just, again, a lack of attention to detail defensively by NC State going back. You'd have to always identify where the ball is, especially when this young man has it.
Third on Markel Johnson, sixth on the Wolfpack. With 8:06 to play. And the free throw from Alvarado. Nine now for Jose Alvarado. Georgia Tech matches their biggest lead of eight. Pretty important, 7:55 to go for NC State. Beverly the three. Moore the rebound.
Beverly now 0-6 from the arc.
Alvarado. Once again, just dribbling in circles here.
He reminds me a little bit of Steve Nash. A guy can get into the lane area. If nothing's happening, he can keep the possession alive and extend it.
Four on Funderburk as we go to break. Seven on NC State. Moses Wright, his fifth three of the year for the Jackets. Their lead is eight when we come back to Raleigh. Georgia Tech at 52-44, 7.5 to go, and Moses Wright, the drive brought to you by Jaguar.
Well, I love the fact that not only can he work in the half court, but runs the floor extremely well, finishes at the rim, and he's having a terrific finish to this year.
Tell you what, he's perfect from the floor, and so is James Banks.
Well, here's the thing, Wes. We talked about it. Second half, Georgia Tech, three turnovers, 12 in the first half. Only 4 second chance points for the Wolfpack, only 4 offensive rebounds. So they shored up the areas they had to from the first half.
Banks missed the free throw. And now Georgia Tech, the zone up 8.
I just think, you know, NC State, they'd be more efficient offensively.
Dorn went for the dunk. And Daniels back in, draws the foul.
And now at the free throw line, makes, and then the full court pressure to come.
This is one of the best dunk misses you'll ever see. If it means anything, which it doesn't. The foul is on Banks. Look at that.
It wasn't by much, and Kevin Keats wanted a foul badly on that play.
Daniels the free throw. He has a dozen. First points for Devin Daniels here in the second half. After a very, very strong first half, especially the close-up. Trying to cut it to 6 and done. 13 for Daniels. How big is the next 7 minutes? Especially for NC State, Mike.
Yeah, I mean, not to say, I mean, you know, the Georgia Tech's out there competing. They want to win as badly as anybody, but it would be a real blow to NC State to lose this home game.
Tend to shoot Alvarado. Trying to measure his bounce.
Travel.
And Wright traveled.
Yeah, he was just in such a hurry to get to the basket. He took those first couple of steps out of the starting block before he put the ball down.
15 for Moses Wright.
And those, you know, when a big does that, it's easier for the referee to make that call. Sometimes the guard might get away with it.
6-point lead. Funderburk in traffic. Had it deflected. And last touched.
Well, dude.
Mike Stevens said, Mike Roberts says it was touched by NC State.
Remember, this is now that only the referees can confer on this. They can't go to the monitor until under 2 minutes.
So Ted Valentine.
They're going to make the change. Ted Valentine came in and overturned that call.
Well, Josh Pastner is completely fired up about the change. Another look here.
It almost looked like a foul on the play, but it didn't look like anybody from Georgia Tech touched it.
Dorn the jumper. Banks the rebound.
Well, Alvarado's got some motor on him, doesn't he?
Well, you capped it in the first half. He's fearless.
And I don't believe he's been off the floor.
Has not. Wright trying to back down Dorn. Misses from the floor for the first time.
And it was a forced shot.
Yep.
Yeah, it was a nice job of getting, not fouled, but moved under the basket. He had nowhere to go.
Here is Daniels trying to find a seam. Now Beverly baseline. Weaving through with a left hand and couldn't finish from in front.
He's starting to get a little with 5:40 left, and
so the Wolfpack have been scoreless from the floor in the last 5 minutes.
Yep.
DeVoe hand check on Markel Johnson. That'll be his fourth. So now Funderburk and Johnson operate with 4, and a 1-1 coming. And so Michael DeVoe will go to the line. Front end of the 1-1. With a freshman from Orlando, just 4 points all here in the second half. And the free throw good. Don't forget this week's ACC All-Access. Jeff Fischel reveals his All-ACC team in women's basketball. Plus, in men's hoop, get to know one of the most prolific scorers in the conference, and that's Kai Bowman of BC. Check your local listings on the Regional Sports Network.
You know, it's interesting, Weston. At free throws, Georgia Tech has pulled everybody off the line. For the front end of the 1-1, they had Moses Wright up there. He makes, they pull him off, and then he misses on. He would have had a chance at that rebound.
7-point game and a missed three. Inside, Doran collects the carom and scores.
All right, they're going to call a foul on Funderburk.
And that's five. DJ Funderburk will foul out of the game with 15 points.
And that is a huge, huge miss coming down the stretch. And yeah, man, it's a call. It looked like, you know, from our vantage point, initially it looked like it was just kept alive, but he got a lot of arm on that play. And that's one, Wes, where you have to understand what your foul situation is and what you can and can't do out on the floor. And you can't waste a foul in that situation.
So no basket for Dorn. Funderburk fouls out with 5:17 to play.
And NC State going, this is the smallest they've gone in the course of the game. So now their shooters are going to have to come up big.
Yeah, Jericho Helms, the biggest guy on the Wolfpack roster at 6'7". Beverly. There's Markell out front. Johnson's second three. He's got eight. Yeah.
This is where he and Dorn have to come up big during this stretch.
NC State's 5 of 27 from three, Mike. Here's Banks. Cuts, more, layup, good. Nice pass, James Banks.
Second great pass is made from up there, and I was thinking about, you know, maybe get him down on the post, but him playing up there, he opens up cutting lanes, and a bad foul.
Khalid Moore.
Yeah, that's a freshman mistake.
Grazed Johnson as he cut it loose. And now Markell Johnson's going to get three fouls out of this. Oh, just barely.
See, I mean, you know, why even go after that? Just, you know, go in front of it, get a hand up, and then make sure you check him out.
71% free throw shooters, the junior Johnson from Cleveland. His assist numbers, Mike, are down from a year ago. In fact, almost half against the league. He averaged 8 assists in conference play last year. It was the highest assist average for an NC State guard since Chris Corciano. And even though those numbers are down, Johnson's health, and you said it earlier in the game, kind of getting back toward 100%, coming off 2 big ball games and now trying to lead to come back here with 3 big free throws, and he's got 11 in the game, 9.5.
Wyatt Walker back in now, so Kevin Keith probably will be going offense for defense. We just need a big body out on the floor.
The ball working against Dorn. Here's the trap. Georgia Tech's got to be careful. There's a pass for Wright.
Well, they got it 1 second to go. We're at the 10-second violation.
Here's Banks. Wyatt Walker defends him. Bounce pass. Alvarado the layup on the Banks bouncer.
I'll tell you what, Banks has played with a lot of poise tonight. And, you know, we're talking about his scoring. He's got 8 rebounds, but that was his 3rd assist.
5-point lead for Georgia Tech. Under 4 to go. Walker sets a nice screen. Johnson the 3. Markell Johnson.
Gotta have that amnesia as a scorer, Wes. Put the rest of the game behind you.
12 and a half, 14 in the game for Markell Johnson. 2-point game coming up on 3 minutes. DeVoe feeds right for another dunk.
All right, talk about those back cuts for scores in this offense, and Torn Dorn got caught peeking that time. Great cut by Wright.
Six assists. Here's Dorn left open for a three. Wright will pull down the rebound and a foul on NC State. That'll get us to a timeout. Wyatt Walker's first. Markell Johnson knocks home a long three from the left. And then at the other end, Moses Wright from Michael DeVoe. Only nine games left in the ACC. Senior night in Raleigh. Torn Dorn being honored before the game. Fast tempo in the opening 20 minutes. A five-point lead for the Wolfpack at break. And here in the second half, we've had plays above the iron. Dunks everywhere. Georgia Tech continuing to shoot 63% from the floor in the ballgame. But, Mike, some caveats. They've only attempted 38 shots from the floor. NC State is 25% from the field here in the second half if Wright misses the front end of two as we come back to live action at PNC Arena.
Yeah, it's 62 to 38 in field goal attempts, but Georgia Tech has made four more. And like I said, they cleaned up the, they've cleaned, taken care of the basketball, cleaned up the defensive glass.
Here's Markell Johnson, quick pass in the corner, Daniels a three. And the rebound for DeVoe.
Wow, this is certainly, you could see shots tightening up a little bit for NC State. They know the enormity of this game. Georgia Tech playing much more loosely.
Here goes DeVoe through traffic, missed everything, and last touched by Torn Dorn. It will belong or stay with Georgia Tech.
In mind, too, Georgia Tech's in the double bonus for the rest of the game, and they have actually a foul to give if they want to.
You see the nine games of five or less for NC State, the five for Georgia Tech. Moses Wright missed the foul line jumper. Braxton Beverly launching and missed everything. 2 minutes to go.
It's hard to believe that Beverly has not made a shot this evening.
Mike, he's got 19 games this year with multiple three-point shots and none tonight. 0 for 7. Banks, here's Wright with 8 to shoot. Moses, the runner, fell off the front for Markell Johnson. 95 seconds left. It's a five-point game.
Yeah, you don't have to go for threes right now.
Johnson does.
Yeah, well, he's the one who's been making shots.
Two-point game. 89 seconds to go in Raleigh. Plenty hanging in the balance for Kevin Keats Wolfpack when we come back.
Georgia Tech with a two-point lead, but Markell Johnson trying to lead his team back. 0 for 2 from 3 in the first half, but he has found the range here in the second half, West. 4 of 7 for him, and this is the one that, they just hit to get back within a deuce.
4 of his last 5 now. 17 for Johnson. Came in averaging 19.5 and shooting 56% from the floor in his last two, including 25 here against Wake Forest. Inbounds Alvarado. Too early to start counting possessions yet.
You know that right now that Georgia Tech is going to be very deliberate, I would imagine, try to run until like 12-second mark.
And remember now, two shots on every common foul when NC State fouls Georgia Tech. They tried to force a turnover. Moore got baseline, and a foul called. Two shots coming on a Wyatt Walker foul.
With 6 seconds left on the shot clock.
So Khalid Moore, a 70% free throw shooter, will go to the line to shoot two.
I don't know about that call either, Wes. I mean, it looked like Walker had the verticality on the play.
First one no good. Moore now 2 out of 5 at the line.
Now this is the first time in the game we've seen guys for Georgia Tech up there for offensive rebounding purposes.
Second one, no good. Two to tie, three to lead for the Wolfpack.
Beverly has that buzzer beater against Clemson earlier this year.
10 to shoot, and here's the guy with the hot hand. Walker helping Johnson. Step back three for the lead. Dorn the rebound. Block Banks. Recovered Alvarado. 33 seconds left. Alvarado leaves it for Wright, who left it on the iron. Walker the rebound. Shot clock off. Good. NC State front court in a timeout.
Timeout.
this is frenetic to say the least. See, Johnson, that was a tough step back shot. Looked like a hard nest shot. Georgia Tech makes a great defensive play. Down the other end, another good recovery. Wow. Couple opportunities missed by both teams. I still think there's enough time to not have to take a three here. Right. You can get a quick two and play the foul game.
So you see the huddle around Kevin Keats. The upcoming schedule for the Wolfpack is brought to you by North Myrtle Beach Convention and Visitors Bureau. And you see not only this one, but Saturday at Chestnut Hill against Boston College, who they beat in overtime here on February the 20th. Now, John Madrew tabulates our numbers, just passed along an important note here. Georgia Tech has a foul to give.
Which I think makes it even more critical for them to attack the basket early. And if they're going to use it, force them to do it as quickly as possible.
Georgia Tech brings back the five that left the floor. Moore, along with Wright, Banks, DeVoe, and Alvarado. And no substitutions for NC State as well. Daniels returns with Johnson, Dorn, Beverly, and Wyatt Walker.
NC State one timeout left, so if they get in trouble here, they have that in their pocket. Georgia Tech with two.
Shot clock off, and here is Markell Johnson in a two-point game. Daniels, Johnson, in the corner with 10. Out front, Dorn for the lead. Timeout, Josh Pastor. Torn Dorn on senior night gives the Wolfpack the lead.
Is it supposed to script out any better, Wes, for a senior? I mean, this place is going crazy. I thought they waited way too long to get into this shot, but everybody forgot where Dorn is. He's a 32% three-point shooter. Certainly not the best on the team, but...
And 0 for 3 tonight going into that one.
Special things happen on senior night.
What a clutch shot by Torn Dorn. And now Georgia Tech has got to go the length of the floor. They have put 0.6 seconds back on the clock.
Maybe a run and jump on Alvarado to try to get the ball out of his hands and make somebody else make a decision. But this is where the loss of Funderburk really hurts North Carolina State as the rim protector behind that.
All right, you mentioned Alvarado. If you're Josh Pastor, who do you want handling the shot here?
Well, I'd run some sort of high pick and roll for him. If NC State, jumps him, I'm going to go Michael DeVoe.
Hit a big three Sunday night against Boston College.
I'd go Michael DeVoe.
Christian Scholen, the young man from Norway, has come into the ball game. He replaces Moses Wright. Now remember, any foul on NC State is two shots for Georgia Tech. And Keats wants to use the timeout here.
They just wanted to see how what they were going to do to set up. It's interesting. They have a bigger cover, Devin Daniels, at 6'5", on Alvarado originally.
You like that idea?
Yeah. I like the size, and also may indicate that he might get some help if Alvarado makes a charge. I like the fact that Alvarado's out by half court. It gives you the whole court to run to the ball.
Well, I go back to something that we heard Josh Pastner talk about today, Mike. You've got to be strong on the inbounds pass when NC State's defending you.
Well, ideally, if you're NC State, you want whoever's catching the ball to have him coming to the ball. You don't want to get him any kind of run up the floor with 6.1 seconds left.
Right. DeVoe will put it in play. Moore and Sholin in the backcourt. Banks and Alvarado at the midcourt line. Here is Alvarado on the catch against Johnson, trying to get to the rim. Feeds Banks for the dunk, and Georgia Tech the lead and a foul with 1 second to go.
Josh Pastner's going crazy because his coaching staff is getting out on the floor, and he didn't want a tech call. We're going to take a look and see about the time on the shot, but look. It's exactly what I said. Alvarado gets it on a full run up the floor and makes a great dish.
John Higgins signaled the basket. There was a foul called on Devin Daniels. So Banks will have a chance for an and one here with 1 second left, or how much time they deem to be left in the ballgame. What an unbelievable finish here.
The stage was set for Dorn to make that play. He made it, give Jose Alvarado all the credit. He made that play happen by himself, and we talked about fearless, right? He went in, drew the defense, made the play.
1.4 left. They put 0.4 seconds back on.
I might miss this on purpose.
All right, there you go. I was getting ready to ask you.
I might miss this on purpose. You're going to have everybody from Georgia Tech back. The only thing he has to do is make sure he hits the rim.
Right. And Georgia Tech has a foul to give as well. The shot.
He took the points.
2-point game. Dorn to put it in play. Bryce at the horn. And Georgia Tech will book in road wins in their ACC schedule. Their first road game was an upset victory at Syracuse. Their last road game, their last regular season game, an improbable win in Raleigh tonight. And certainly some damage done to NC State's bubble chances.
It is a huge, huge blow, Wes. And it makes the Boston College game now it's an absolute must-win to get to 500.
Mike, what a remarkable last two ends of the floor here.
No, just incredible drama, and you feel for Torn Dorn. Look at this. He thought this was the moment of his career. To knock down the three, and then Georgia Tech brought it right from the start, and this guy right here led most of the way, and once again it was their bigs that finished inside.
Yep. James Banks started fast early and capped a remarkable road win for Georgia Tech. 19 points tonight for Banks, and Georgia Tech picks up their 14th win. They will finish the ACC campaign at 6-12. Great to be with Mike Jaminski tonight. Our producer, Alex Farmartino, our director, Johnny Tyus. Don't forget, more ACC basketball on Saturday. NC State's at Conti Forum to meet Boston College.